It's November 10th. Just got the dump truck back. They had to cut that whole piece off the front because someone had welded it around the bottom radiator tube, radiator hose, and you couldn't replace it without cutting the front. That thing they had for an old plow, I guess. Anyway, it got two new batteries, an alternator, fuel system had to be fixed. So that came to $700 there. Then they got a new lift. We paid $500 for the lift. And I don't know how much it's going to cost that thing to been put on, but it didn't lift nearly that good before. I got that lift, the electric hydraulic lift from Northern Tool for $499, and the only thing he had to do was get a different hydraulic line. I don't even see the hydraulic line. Oh, there it is. Different hydraulic lines, the ends form. Here's the old one. It's seen its better days. So it goes down real smooth now. Look at that. Like a dump truck's supposed to. Might have to put some rubber on that that thing that it comes down on. Now the only thing we need to do to it is, I think, ball joints and tie rod ends, and then I'll probably this summer, I was going to trade her to a guy for a bigger dump truck, but I don't, now that I put $2,000 in it, I'm not going to do that. I'll probably sand her down, fix the holes, maybe hit her with some paint. So she'll do what we need anyway, as long as she keeps running. December 27th, 10 a.m., and it's at least 60 degrees. I saw a big fish jump down here. I'm almost tempted to throw a line in my pond. Look, there's another one. They feeding on something. I think I'm going to go over to my neighbor's pond right over there and see what's happening over there. Let's see what his little pond's got in it. Too bad I can't find my glasses I lost over here this summer. They're down in there somewhere. Let's see if we can catch something. It's crystal clear. Anyway, let's try a worm first. And I got the little Abu Garcia Cardinal DM3, I think. Friday, it's January 1st, 2016. It's 44 degrees. No snow yet this year, thank goodness. So all I got done last year was plowing snow. It's a little too cold to fish on the pond.
what a difference a year makes. January 1st, 2016, last year, I had gone through twice as much hay. So all we had was snow from October all the way to March. We haven't had any snow this year yet. It's only been a couple nights. It's been in the 20s. And usually we're around zero. This is the sheep hay here. They eat in a bale. We got rid of half of the sheep this year. We had about 120. Now we got about 65. Maybe 70. So, this second cutting sheep hay, they're eating a bale about every four. I actually got them split up in two fields. There's 35 in one field and 30 in the other. So they're eating a bale about every four and a half days. So it's staying pretty nice. I cleaned this out this year. This was where all my equipment and old scrap and everything else was at. It's where I had it all stuffed in here. Still got a couple remnants that needs to be cleaned up. Wind's starting to pick up a bit. Usually it's windy as heck in January. Snowy and windy. Shenandoah Mountain, Jack Mountain. Right smack dab in the middle. 3170. And 3,300 feet. We're at 2,800 feet farming. We're in the Appalachian Mountains. We're on the border. West Virginia's 20 miles. Actually, if you go straight across, it's less than that. It's probably like 17. Maybe not even that far. If you go straight, 20 miles. West Virginia line. Last year's wood. That's where I got all that topsoil dug out, right there. Using them garden boxes. There's a house in the woods back here. Old man owned it, died about 5 years ago. His granddaughter, I think, comes in now. There's a house a mile away. Got one neighbor. The house is across from us is a the guy only comes in once in a while from New York. So it's quiet. Except for me running my mouth, it's quiet. Still haven't got the hay wagon unloaded. Big surprise there, huh? It's supposed to go into that barn. However, it's been raining. You can see it's been rain. This is just from the skid loader. Just think if I try to carry that 15,000 pounds maybe. Think if I try to pull that in the back lot. It's nothing but mush. Can't even get near the barn to put it up. Rained for almost a month. In fact, I got stuck the other day out there in the field. That's why the bale's right here by the gate. I'm going to make some bins for mulch and gravel and stuff out of these old posts that used to go across there and down the fence line and make some bends that way. And then where I dug this out, I'm going to continue to come back with this, getting this topsoil, and I'm going to mound up and use some of that, those posts for my shooting range, which will be through this spot here. So it should be pretty decent. That's a game plan anyway. It's been a game plan for like 3 years. Half the stuff I talk to the camera about never makes it anywhere but on the hard drive. Usually it's just ramblings to myself. So I fixed the cabin up, gutted it. It's a combination old trailer, and then they built a whole side of it. Anyway, I gutted it. When I finally do get around to fixing it, it'll be a nice cabin, because it ain't gonna, I can strip all that trailer stuff off of that. Only little part that's left is the trailer, is that little front used to be the kitchen. The water line broke over there about 5 years ago, and I still haven't got it dug up. It's gonna be about $4,000. So until I get $4,000, the cabin's just sitting there going to shit. Could, you know, if I fixed it up, it could be a nice hunter's cabin to rent out, or a place for me to store my crap. I knew you were going to waltz on over here. You gotta be Amber. Who else could you be? I can't tell. No, no, you're not Amber. There's another one that's been really friendly lately. I don't want lickings. I don't want lickings. I know, there's salt on our skin that they like. That's why they do that. Can I rub? Can I rub? You've been rolling around in the hay, haven't you? Can I rub? Where have you been in the mud, young lady? You're not Amber either. Where have you been? I don't have no snacks today. So much better than cutting them stupid strings. There's a little bite. Look at her little mug. A bell down there. They can go out that around that gate down there, but they will stand there tomorrow when they up in tomorrow morning. They usually up in this field messing around. They'll find her. Little worms. There's the buck right there. See how many's over here. There's the buck. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 16, 17, 18, 19. 32 of them over here. Hey, you worms. I got nothing for you guys except for hay. Nothing except hay. Look at the little burrs stuck in their fur. Even mess around that grass down the middle. I need to get a guy that's going to dig out the stream again because it's pretty much getting covered back up. And now it's spreading out and creating this burrs and grass and stuff. So it needs to be dug out all the way down. But it's going to be like $1,300 for each field. So that's not happening anytime soon. Started when he put in these waters, he started and done a little bit because he had to get the water to get away from where he was putting in the these waters. Hey, you crazy coot, that was my shirt that pulled it out from under my jacket. Look at the green grass right there in January. You know, y'all can go around. You can go around. They still see that bale down there? There's still half of a bale. They won't get this one till tomorrow. They'll probably be over there by midnight. Looks like the girls have gave you a workout. Come here. They'll try to take your little nubs off. Alright, see ya. Bring this sheep in this field, this front field. Bring their bill. I'm done for the day. They still had some left too. See the buck in this field. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17. Only 17. They're coming up from down in the gully. 18. Probably down there at the stream. 19. It's a stream that goes up on the pond down through there. Well, don't chance it. It's so soft, you can't really go too far in the fields. Leaving big ruts. They wasn't going to put a gate here. I had to beg the fence guy. Said it wouldn't be sturdy in the corner like that. Didn't recommend it. Didn't recommend it. I said, well, why can't you curve it, put 4 or 5 supports in. and do it right here. If they did it, I wasn't backing down. Don't back down. I know, don't sing. My singing days were over. Long over. Look at them. Alright, time to put this machine away. Need to hose her off, but it's a little too chilly. The sun dropped, I think. It's probably about 38, 39. Other boat. Make sure no mice have gotten into it. There's the John boat. I'm gonna get that working on that here in the next week or two. Haven't been able to use this building yet because the guy didn't put the floor in it. Screwed us. Big time. So I got some shell, I was starting to do it myself, and then that's where the skin loader busted the main line. And I haven't tried it yet again. The sunbird boat in here. There's a motorcycle that's going. I don't know if you can see it. Got it all ready to go tomorrow. I guess I'll park the Grady White in there and put that one over there for now. We'll see which one I'm going to keep. If I don't keep them all, I'm done for the day. Did my 4 hours. Some days you do 10 to 12 hours. But on the average, get that razor blade. That could have been in the tire. You can see where that other cow is. I'm missing a cow. Missing a cow. What do you think of that? What do you think? Missing a cow. They pretty old. Going on 17 years, some of them, if not older. So. Let's hope nothing happened to it. Nowhere. Make sure no one's left this gate open. Somebody's over here. It's only 2 days left of hunting season. See no cow. Just digging four-wheel drive. So I don't get stuck. See no cow anywhere. Sometimes they have their babies down in there. She could be down in there with a baby. She could have have jumped out if they left the gate and be down the road too. The pup's starting to learn a little bit more about farming. The pup is learning a little bit more about farming. He's staying in the back for some reason. Well, cows ain't been over here much. Somebody had mowed my field, and I intentionally didn't mow it so there would be some grass for the winter. And somebody come over and mowed this field. There's this tractor right there. I don't know why he did it. Can't do nothing about it once it's done. Can't do nothing about it once it's done. At least I ain't gotta mow it in the spring. I reckon.